Yeah, dear Commissioner, dear colleagues, COVID is hitting hard in several parts of the world. But in a lot of Latin American countries, the pandemic is having devastating effects. And it is for this reason that today, here in the European Parliament, we express our condolences and our deepest solidarity with the people in Latin America. And we call on the European Union to step up its support. But let me turn to one country that was most hit. Almost 400,000 Brazilians have died, and this is a real tragedy. But a tragedy that could have prevented and that was caused by deliberate political decisions. For no government, it is easy to fight the pandemic. But it is a difference if you try or if you just refuse. Since the beginning of the crisis, President Bolsonaro has denied to adopt science-based measures to contain COVID. He has consistently downplayed the severity of the virus. He has encouraged large gatherings of people. He has repeatedly spoken against vaccination and mask wearing. He even tried to take governors to court for implementing local measures, such as partial lockdowns. And now, almost 400,000 humans dead. Sadly, those who are most vulnerable are also the ones suffering the most. Over 50,000 cases of COVID have been confirmed among indigenous people in Brazil, with more than 1,000 deaths. The number of Brazilians living in poverty has tripled. 19 million Brazilians have gone hungry due to the pandemic. And that is why today I call on the Brazilian authorities to urgently implement a science-based approach to managing the pandemic and to take measures to address its social and human rights consequences. And the EU needs to step up its support and especially accelerate global vaccine distribution, because here the gap between the global north and the global south is shamefully huge. Thank you.